Today, I'll be showing you how to create an underwater title sequence in HitFilm. You can download this project file right now for free on the preset marketplace. I'm Javert Valbar for inScapedigital.com. Let's get started. For this to work in Express, you need to have purchased the atmospheric lighting pack for the volumetric light and gleam effects. I started this scene by importing the ocean template from the preset marketplace. It was one of the first I created and uploaded, so if you're new here, you might not know that it exists. I'll walk you through how to download and use it now, just in case. The preset is currently on the fourth page of the marketplace, so I'll go over and click this link icon to instantly download it. Navigate to your downloads folder and unzip it. Inside, you'll find a single project file. Here in HitFilm, I'll go to Import Composite Shot. I'll find the folder I just downloaded and click on the ocean.hfp file. This will load up the camera and effects, all ready to use. I'll rename this composite Ocean Surface. For this scene, I want my camera below the layer. I'll highlight it and hit Command-R, which will reset the position. Go into the Controls panel and set the camera to -700Y. And about 2300Z to put us under it. In the controls for the ocean layer, set the X rotation to 100, so that it's angled down towards the camera. I'll come over to New Layer and add a light. I'll move the position down until the ocean layer falls off into shadow. There's one step with the ocean preset that I wasn't able to include with the template, and that's adding an environment map with a picture. I have this photo of clouds that I like to use. I'll import it, then drag it down into the timeline and hide it from view. Navigate over to the Caustics property on the ocean layer. Come down to Environment Map and set the layer to the clouds picture. You can see it instantly adds coloration and lighting that makes it look more realistic. Let's create a new composite shot, which will be our main comp. The reason I don't put it all in one is because I can now render a proxy for the ocean surface composite, which will speed it up when we use it in here later. I'll drag the plane from the media panel into the timeline. Name it BG for background, then duplicate it. Add the radial gradient effect onto the top layer. Under center, set the Y position to 545, or to just the top of the frame. I'll come down to inner radius and set the color to blue. Now increase the outer radius and set the color to black. The last thing I'll do is set the elliptical deformation to around 0.5. Let's bring in the ocean surface composite. I'll come up and select the ellipse mask tool. I'll draw a shape near the top center. Then come into the controls panel and feather it. I'll duplicate the layer and flip it 180 degrees. This will become the ocean floor, so I'll move it down in the frame. I added the hue colorize effect to make it look more sandy brown. Let's add auto volumetrics to the surface layer. First, I'll raise the position to be above the frame. Next, I'll adjust the controls until there are subtle beams of light. Changing the threshold will result in less light rays, and exposure affects the brightness. I'll also come down here to colorize, and set them to be slightly blue or white, depending on your final look. Now I'll add a gleam effect. Like the volumetrics, move the position to above the ocean surface. I raised the minimum value and lowered the maximum, so that less of the scene would be affected. Then set the blending mode to screen. It'll look a little rough, so add a diffuse effect to soften it up. Once you have the rays looking how you like, drag in the plane from the media panel. I'll go ahead and add the fractal noise effect. If you're using HitFilm Pro 2017, set the type to energy. If you have a lower version, you can still use the effect, but you just won't have the energy type. I'll hit the keyframe button for seed. Skip to the end and set it to around 4. This will make it move throughout the shot. In the transform controls, I'll increase the scale to about 300. Set the blending mode to overlay to give your scene dark and light spots. If it's too drastic, lower the opacity of that layer. Our final layer will be a grade for color grading. I use the curves effect to change the overall hue of the scene, lowering the red channel and adding a bit of green into the highlights. I put on two glow effects to further soften the light rays above. Like the previous few tutorials, I use Levels Histogram to make sure my shadows and highlights were in the correct spots. Finally, I added Bleach Bypass and some film grain. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Let me know if you have any questions below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.